Good afternoon and good day, my folk in Europe and America, even in Australia. I have to start with the official report from NASA via spaceweather.com. We are now so surprised that Sunspot 3514 had explored X-ray. Before that, this spot still very weak, very small one, but it grow up about 10 times, 15 times in less than 6 hours, and it produced X-ray and multiple M-ray. What I have to say that it impossible for the sun that can create this solar flare, and this is the first extreme solar flare in solar cycle 25. It's pretty weird, and this one should reach Earth in about 20 to 24 hours. Why I say that? Because the speed of this solar flare is about almost 3,000 kilometers per second. When you time 60 to be minutes and time another 60 to be hours, very fast, pretty fast. Okay, better. You can see that if you take a look for the 7-day solar activity, right? It starts right here, X-ray and multiple. Today it's about 3 M-3 M-fares. It's so surprise. For us, nobody realized that the sun will export the huge solar flare like this. And of course, this solar flare from this sunspot 3514 will hit Earth. Right now, the radiation from this sunspot still releases to Earth. Whoever live in the daylight, right now you have to take good care of yourself. The radiation right here still release continue at very long duration. It's not good. And the next one maybe this one should release another M class too. Both sunspots will hit Earth directly. I talk about this one first, and I will tell you later about the poor ship that not come from solar flare or not come from our sun, but come from the others. Take a look at different angstrom, different frequency. And don't be panic, that's the moon past the camera of the satellite. One more passing. Take a look. You can see that so many fair, so many fair, and the moon passed very quick. Sunspot 3514. You see? Pretty big. Not only the sunspot, the filament around this area is really huge too. This filament and this one could release from the sun and to be the CME, another powerful energy that can impact Earth. Sorry that NASA still do not update the fact that the Earth is from the M class earlier, right? To M class that right now already impact our Earth. To M class, the first one and the second one behind right here. But for the X class and for the 3M class today, they did not generate yet. So you can see only 2M fair impact us on 15 and 16. Tomorrow, NASA should simulate about the X fair that should hit us in about 20 to 24 hours. It's so strong, it's so fast. It is just only M fair, only 2M fair that is. Radiation is come down right now. About 1 hour earlier, it's still really strong. Solar wind is about 700 something. Right now, it decreased to 400 to 500. This is what I worry about. You can see that the impact of radiation at Indian Ocean. So when the CME comes to hit Earth, it should hit around this area too. It should be like that. You can expect more about huge earthquake, but at this point, I still did not see any clue about the tsunami right here, but who knows, because I have the lack of information. I'm sick for many days. Multiple CME or direction, you can see that. The big one, this side, another one here. So the solar flare effect all star in our solar system and to the other two. Oh, today not too good. It changed a lot. Because this one online real time, right? It changed a lot, but here you can see that the impact of the CME will reach in about 1 or 2 seconds. Again, more energy at the back, not from the front. Front right here, of course, it comes from our sun, but in the back it's not. Take a look one more time. Can see that? So strong energy surround Earth. Most on this side and this one, not from the front. The sun right here, the sun right here. So usually come in the back. Now CME hitting Earth. Yesterday, right, I shared the photo from our folk from the state about the Venerable Bell or our Earth magnetic shield that dropped down under the satellite orbit. Right now, Venerable Bell is still very weak. You can see that pretty close to the satellite orbit again. But why it looked that good shape? Because right now we receive the energy from the sun. The sun explosion, the CME. CME can fulfill the energy at the Earth core. So the shape of the Venerable Bell is pretty good, but it very pretty weak and close to the satellite orbit. Take a look at this animation. Look at the arrow right here. It's again the arrow that indicates solar wind solar storm from our sun. You see that? Therefore, right here, around this area, there are strong impact of the energy that not come from our sun. This impact much stronger than our solar wind, because they can roll against our solar wind, our solar storm. Right now it's about 460 something. And again, for the IMF right here is not from our sun, from the other sun or the other object that come close to the Earth in the back. IMF line this one from our sun, but this arrow shape not from our sun. Why Earth magnetic at the north and the south look pretty good shape again? Because our Earth core receive the energy from the sun via CME. It's good to the Earth too, right? We can keep the energy in the Earth core. Then Earth can produce strong magnetic at the north and at the south, much more at the cycle. But in about 2 days, after the CME has blown past our Earth, north and south will be pretty weak again. Almost 15 days, I have observed about the wave activity at Pacific Ocean. The water moved from the west to the east. You can see that. Take a look from the Great Barrier Reef at the Australia. Look at the shape of the wave. The first one and the second one that are almost beside each other. You can see the top of the wave. Water move from west to the east. Right here indicate about the southern of Philippine plate. Again, look at the top, at the top of the wave. For Japan, can see that? Another void between Japan and Russia. Not at good shape at all. Down here in New Zealand. It looks pretty good, okay. North Pacific has much more activity than the South Pacific. It's nearby Vancouver, okay, and Vancouver and Oregon. Look at the top of the wave. My leg hurt me. Sorry that I cannot speak very well. I sit down for a long time. Not good for me. Yeah, in Central America, another assumption, we can say that right now it looks like that Earth rotates slower and slower every day, every minute. Therefore, the water move forward. Nothing good at all. You have to prepare everything for yourself. As I had indicated a long time ago, that the water level, okay, southern of Sumatra, western of Australia, the water dropped down more than 1,000 meters. And at the Andaman Sea, the water dropped down about 16 meters for many years. Where's the water gone? They're gone to the gap between Earth crust and magma layer. That show you. I would rather to write an article and share to you. You might understand more than I make the live presentation. Any more information, I shall let you know very soon. Yet, guessing, some big quake in forecast again. That's the beginning. Yes, the seawater, okay, move from west to east. Only one assumption. Earth rotate slow, right? Then the water move forward. Because Earth is too slow. If Earth rotation too fast, the water will back to Asia, not to America. Now it's slow. How long the Earth rotation has been slow? More than a year. Nobody really observed about this thing. But the full information, I believe that both NASA and JEMA, they realized about this phenomena that really happened. I shall plan and tell myself to write the article about 2 to 4 pages to declare what will happen within this coming Christmas and New Year. Don't worry about the poor ship. The poor ship not within this year. But the big event, big quake, should be checked the whole world before New Year. And again, you have to help yourself by try to use this webpage information that we call floodmap.net and set up right here. The number about 500 meter, because when the poor ship happened, okay, the tidal wave, okay, the tidal wave, okay, will high about 300 to 400 meter, and splash maybe up to 500 meter, or in other words, it's about 1800 to 2000 feet from the Minsi review. Check the area that you live. Therefore, I try my best to emphasize everybody that when the pole shift occur, you should stay at the high ground about 2,000 feet. You can get a good sleep and you don't need to worry anything else in the state in Europe. I'm sorry that I have to show this picture to you again for you to prepare in the worst case scenario for yourself. I pray and I wish the wave should not higher than 2,000 feet. Right now, right here, it is my base, my area, okay? My underground bunker, my shelter, and the food reserve, medicine reserve right here to help the people in case of the poor ship. Here is my place. But if I shoot the GPS, right, it indicates another place. Take a look. EMF, solar storm, had effect to the satellite, to the GPS. So right now, many airplanes have double check and maybe use the radio frequency to talk to the tower about their hat. Nothing good at all from time to time. It's almost about 50 kilometers from where I live. Get that? Try your best. It is not my point. But the Google indicates where I am now. It's not true. Talk to you soon. Sorry that today not too good.